arts know of art and craft. Art and craft shop with arts and there.
Hi friends, I'm Jagan from Raj Noho Arts and Crafts. Today I'm going to show you the tutorial 6 of the making of 3D Meenakshi Tanjore painting. So in this tutorial we are going to see the coloring process, full coloring from the start to the end. If you have not subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe so that you can see the next videos that we will be posting regularly. If you have missed the previous video, just click the I button above or check below description, and we have posted all the details. My wife Dr. Mahalakshmi's tutorial 6 is on the way right now, so kindly try yourself and waiting for your valuable comments. In Tanjore painting we use only poster colors. In poster colors also there are two different types. One is student based colors and artist based colors. And this is a Camlin artist poster color with 12 shade box. This is available default. And this one is a unique poster color kit where these 15 shades are not available on that 12 shade box. And there is a fluorescent poster color kit also is available. So we are going to use these colors in this 3D Meenakshi Tanjore painting. For high detailing you can use these long detailed brushes. You can get a very good detailed work in it. And this is step 1, that is activating the poster color. Whenever you are starting a poster color work, you have to activate the colors by adding 2 to 3 drops of water and stir well with brush. This process activates the pigments in your poster color and thereby no cracks or lumps will be formed while coloring. Maintain a cloth for drying the brushes and please don't add too much of water in while activating as it may degrade your colors. And step 2 is store the bottle in upside down position so that your colors won't dry easily. From the garland, let us start the coloring process. We will be displaying the colors used. You can also follow the same colors when you are practicing on your paintings. Step 3 is varying your shades. In this garland we have used outer side is light green and inner side is dark green, which resembles the tulasi of a garland. Likewise you have to vary the shade between light green and dark green. Even here you can see the inner side of the garland. We are coating with a red color for the roses, or the outer side of the garland we are coating with a special pink. Step 5, this is the most important step, that is base coating. We are going to base color the areas the paint is required to be colored. Base coloring is also called as reactivating. You can see here we are changing the colors now, that is the special pink. Before that you have to clean the brush with the white cloth, then only you have to add the next color, or else the color combination will not give you the desired results. Step 6 is reactivating your colors. Reactivating in the sense when you are mixing special pink and red color, when you are mixing together, that is blending together, both the colors give a new color combination. That is known as reactivation of poster color, and that will bring a very unique look for your poster painting. So you can note that even the embossed areas of this garland are colored now. And we are using two techniques while detailing. We will be showing that two techniques of the detailed work. Now we are doing all the things as base coloring step only. So all the areas will be base colored. And this is the yellow ochre that we are using with some white color in it, and lemon yellow mixed with white color. And thereby we are reactivating, that is mixing both the colors and bringing a new combination of colors. Step 7 is the most important thing, that is washing the poster color. Always remember that when you are doing poster color work, you have to wash the poster colors. That is washing in the sense when you are applying the colors on any of the areas, you have to take in a palette 50% of the colors and 50% should be water, so that it will be in a diluted form. That is what I am trying to say. This orange, that is the inner side we are putting, is not washing technique. This is base coloring technique. But washing technique we will be showing while doing screens, and also mainly the face and eyes, and also the hands, legs, etc. Madurai is famous for its jasmine flower. None of the countries or none of the states have jasmine flower except Madurai. The smell of jasmine flower is very unique for us. Same thing, our Meenakshi is also wearing the inner garland as jasmine garland filled with marikolundu and ganagambaram flowers. Now for designing the saree, we are using medium green. You can also use poster green or dark green, but this is the medium green that we like the most. And Meenakshi means green saree mostly. Especially in Tanjore painting, there are many codes for the cloths of the god. For example, white saree is for Saraswati, pink saree for Mahalakshmi, yellow color for Murugan and also our Ganapati, red color for Kamachi, and tiger color, that is the tiger striped colors, for Shiva and Natarajar, blue with gold or full gold for Balaji and Krishna. Themes. So we are base coloring the face with olive green and Vandy brown, and you can also use dark green and Vandy brown, or dark green with black also. We wanted to make the face to be like stone, like same like you see in Meenakshi Amman temple. So we are using this statue technique. You can also use the coloring technique like flesh color also you can add, or you can do the light green with flesh color technique also. The whole statue of Meenakshi is made of emerald, which is green in color, that is dark green in color. The same thing we are replicating here in this painting. This color combination gives a realistic view when taken as a photo. That is, when you are seeing the statue in this Tanjore painting, it will be greenish black, like that only it will be depicting. So it will be a realistic view. Even after years it will be the same. And now we are designing the feet also on the gold foil. You can use the poster color, even if you wipe it with the cloth, it won't come out. Now Madurai Meenakshi face, body, legs and also the hands are all being colored. After that, other areas like Sangu and also the Beedam and some other background areas will also be colored with base coat colors. So let me answer some of the customer queries. The first question is, can we use fabric or acrylic paint instead of poster colors in Tanjore painting? My answer to this question is a big no. Acrylic paint are not powder coated paint, so the opaqueness that you get in poster colors are missing with the acrylic paint. The second thing is, after 10 years, 20 years, the acrylic paint may fade away, but the poster colors won't, as it will be depicting the same opaqueness even after 20-30 years. Let me introduce this minute brush set. It has 0000 and a liner and a 40, that is 0x18 will be there, which will be more minute and used for making such a detailed work. So step 9 is start detailing on the base colors. We have used 000 brush for detailing this garland. You can see how we are detailing this garland. One C on this side, another C on the other side, and the next big C. So you are going to just put 4 C's, that is the capital C. So you will be getting a flower like projection on the projected circle. We are going to repeat this same step on each and every circle on the garland. Thereby it resembles the rose of a flower. In the bottom of this garland, we have done a 3D embossed rose with the help of a 3D clay that is molded, which we have shown in tutorial 3. For those people who are unable to follow that technique, this technique is very easy. Just you have to make some circles on the garland, and while painting you have to put the C and inverted C in it. Thereby your garland is getting ready. This is one of the basic painting technique for garland. There are many more techniques that we are teaching in our art center. For tanjore painting classes, you can just WhatsApp us and we will be telling you the details. And you can see here how the garland is getting ready with this. We have used here the pink, normal pink and white color to get a rose-like color, which you can see here is very realistic and very beautiful for this Meenakshi. This same garland technique you can follow in flat work also. This is the embossed rose flower, which gives a very good realistic effect. If you have more time and if you are doing it for your own paintings, you can make this embossed garland and color in this same manner and get your finishing done. So there will be a difference. You can see how the garland is differing with that technique and this technique. You can use this garland technique in Balaji, Andal, Meenakshi and Saraswati, even Vinayagar also. And there are many other flower technique like lotus technique, jasmine technique and also lily flowers and many more flowers to which are used in tanjore painting. And this is also the shading. We have using the fluorescent colors, that is the fluorescent yellow is used. And you can see here how the tulasi and pachai, they will be telling in Tamil. So those are glittering and giving a very realistic effect. And now you can see here we are shading this with light green and white. And for this you can see the inside of the mala garland, the light green and white, there is a difference. The outer is fluorescent yellow and inside of this is light green with white. And now we are washing it slightly to get a light shadow or the shades of the garland to be perfect. Many artists have many different coloring technique according to their experience. It differs, but this is our own experience. So you can see here how we are getting the results, that is what we are displaying in this videos. For viewers, you can try your own experience in shading, coloring, painting and bring out your own uniqueness in your paintings. So this is the way that we are doing and getting the success. So this is the golden yellow and orange. We are giving this combination. So this gives a very good highlight for the inner garland when compared to the outer garland. I requested my wife to use most of the colors and we are also using the same in this tanjore painting. The base color of this parrot is leaf green, and how nice it is looking and getting embossed with a cone work done on it. It is said that this parrot always reminds Meenakshi about our wishes. Again and again, as Queen Meenakshi is quite busy in ruling our Madurai. The pinkish red parrot is the most fascinating pet for our Meenakshi. So now we are going to color the screen background, that is we are using violet and also magenta for lining. Here we are base coloring the screen as a line form. Always we do it as a opaque, that is full base coloring we will be doing, but here the base coloring is done as a line form with the violet color on both the sides of the screen. We are making the background with a number 2 brush. You can also use number 4, it is according to your wish. And the main thing is, for background you have to use dark colors, then only your Meenakshi or the or any other god will be differentiated with the background, that is clearly visible with the background. The most colors used in background are red, blue, green, and also fluorescent green, and many other colors combination, that is magenta also is used. But here we want to use different uniqueness, so we have brought violet in this with the magenta combination, and this one is the magenta color. And you can see here we are base coloring the second color, that is magenta color, in the gaps of the violet color. So likewise you have to continue it to the full screen, and then we will be washing it, that is merging it. And you can also use gold as a dots. So here many people they use gold dots, and thereby it brings a border like effect for the screens. Next query is, can we use student grade poster color instead of artist grade, as I am not getting it immediately? Artist grade poster color has high pigment in it and less residue, so when colored on the background or on the board, they give a reflect a very good color combination. But student color, they have less pigment in them and high residue, so the color combination won't be so attractive and vibrant when compared to the artist range poster color. In the background of the screen, that is the lower screen, we have used scarlet, so you can get a very good brimming effect on the background of Meenakshi. So now we are going to wash the screen, and to create a nice smooth wash, use soft bristle brushes and work each stroke in one direction only, rather than scrubbing back and forth. For an even coat, use the brush slightly overlapping each successive strokes. So now you can see how we are washing it with the, this is thick washing. So when the water is more and the colors are less, it is called as the thin washing. And that you can do it on saris of the Saraswati or dhotis of Ganapati, you can do that. And there will, you can do it with 3 to 4 times of successive strokes, thereby you will be getting a very good results. In this screen we are highlighting with carmine, we don't want the gold. You can also highlight it with gold like this, so you can get a very good results. Now we are mixing poster green and black as a combination, and we are going to highlight the corners of the saree. That is, we are going to make the saree distinct from the jewels. So to make them seem distinct, we are going to shade the borders of the saree wherever it is overlapping the jewels. And next query is, which brush is highly suitable for Tanjore painting or poster coloring? If you think of coloring, then the senior artist always tell that Jaina brushes, that is the animal hair brushes or squirrel hair brushes, but that is completely banned in India. Those animal hair brushes give very good, that is 100% results, that is washing tech for washing, it is of 100% result they give. But the thing is, selling them in a store is a great offense according to our government. So there comes a replacement, that is synthetic hair brushes, but these also are giving a very good result, not like animal hair brushes, but at par to them it is giving. And because this is the only option that we have at present, so we sell both the round and flat brush as a set form or also as an individual set. You can buy them directly by just a WhatsApp to our number. And this is the minute brush that we are using for detailing work. This, it is coming as a set form also, quite economical. So you can use these type of brushes rather than the animal hair brushes and save the precious animal becoming extinct. The main thing of these synthetic hair brushes is that the water trenching capacity is the same as compared to the animal hair brushes. Water trenching capacity means the mileage that the brush is taking the paint till its last minute. And secondly, the control that you get with these synthetic hair brushes is the same like the animal hair brushes. Now the corners of the screen has been brightened with the black color, and now we are going to see the sari section. That is, we are using poster green and light green for designing the sari. So we are using the washing technique in a medium format. The saris of Meenakshi is covered with jewels, so only we are using this medium format. If there is no jewels or any other disturbance, then you can use the low format, that is water in high level, colors in low level with a gradation in it. We have also used the fluorescent green also in this Meenakshi, a combination color, so that it looks quite bright as the sari is very dark. So now the sari is ready. Now we are making the outer background ready with the Vandy brown color, and this is not the background, this is the floor color. So we will be making this as a tile and also making some decorations in it and doing some varnish also in that. So with a black and green combination, we are highlighting the saris between the lines, and also the hands also you have to highlight it. Here we have used full black, thereby a small shading we will be getting with the hands. So here also we are using the same washing technique. You can see here how we are washing it with a black color, and you can see two different shades, and this is the light we are giving for that hands. So just you have to add some poster white in this, where you will be getting a gray color like theme. So you should wash it on the corners of the hand, even in between the fingers, thereby it looks like a real statue. When you look at a real statue, there will be a dark and light reflections. So the same effect we are bringing in this Meenakshi's hand. In both the hands will be getting ready, and then only it gives a very good detailing of your work. Even you can see in this left hand, the fingers and the jewels are not disturbed, only the black colors are shaded, thereby giving a very good realistic fingers and bringing the live effect for Meenakshi. And the next query is how to use the brushes while doing poster color work. You can use round brushes for detailing work, and in detailing also you have to split it into two, that is minute detailing. You can use the liner brushes or that minute tiny brushes like 0x18 or 000, 00 like that. And for high detailing like sari detailing, you can use number 2, number 3, number 4 size brushes like number 8, 10, 12. All these you can use these for doing a board, that is Tanjore painting board 24x36. 36x48. For those, if you are doing, you can use those brushes. It will be very helpful for detailing. And also there are many tips in holding the brushes. If you are using a minute detailing part, you have to hold it, that is close to the ferrule. And if you are doing a like a tree or like a background part, you have to hold your brushes loosely towards the end of the handle and draw lines with a fluid movement. The lines get thinner as you drag your paint brushes, and it helps gently to rotate the brush between your fingers, and you can keep the line varied. And more important, you can use the paint on all sides of the bristles. While the paint is still wet on the background, you can create gradation of colors by knitting the various tones of colors together using carefully controlled brushwork. So in general, big brushes are good for loose style of painting and small brushes are good for details. How small the brush, should depend on the size of the work and on your style. Miniature artists even use very tiny minute brushes that have only few hairs. So 0, 1, 2, 000, 000 are the brushes which are recommended for final touches. It is more important to see the light and dark shade in each and every area of legs and hands that you do in tangier painting. The best way to see the difference in the value is to squint your eyes. Look at your painting, squeezing your eyes and using your eyelashes as a filter, and it will be easier to see the value of each stroke that you are making in your paintings. So now we are going to make the background colors, that is the outer background. The inner background we have filled up with the screen. Now the outer background is with the black with brown. So this is the raw sienna that we are using, not the yellow ochre. And this is in the outer background. The main colors used are Prussian blue, green, that is poster green, crimson, and also magenta also is used. But here we want to show some uniqueness in the outer area. So we are using this raw sienna and this is burnt umber. So these two colors we are going to wash it, and you can see here we are using the low wash technique in this background. So we are going to merge it equally so that it looks like a wall of a temple. So after adding the colors on the background, that is the burnt umber on all the sides, we don't touch the brush with the paint. So we are going to touch the brush only with water, and we are going to smudge it, that is merge the two colors so that there will be a new color combination and a new color variant will be coming. So this is what you are going to see, and you can see here all the sides of Tiruvachi is being surrounded with raw sienna and burnt umber. Please make ensure that the background that you do for your painting should be darker. Traditionally, the most used background are Prussian blue, or sometimes Prussian blue combined with black color and red color, crimson and poster green, and sometimes they use Camlin blue or ultramarine blue for Krishna themes, etc. So now you can see here, without adding any paint, only with water we are merging it or washing it. You can see here we are just taking the water and applying on all the sides and merging it, and this is one of the low washing technique. And this, when you are doing it on a sari, it will be coming in a very good, beautiful step-by-step form. Here we have done with two colors, so this is also called as the merging technique. And this is the complex pen. Since this is a coloring part, you can also use this complex pen and ink, that is the rotary ink, black ink, for coloring your gold foil and even some of your saris also. If you are unable to do it with your brush, you can use this rotary ink for coloring effect. For mala designing also you can use this. You can check in detail the tutorial 5, gold foil coloring, or we have put in description a separate video on this complex pen, how to use it. You can please watch it and kindly do subscribe our channel. So only after using this complex pen ink, your work, the gold foil work, becomes complete. And this one is the next step, that is adding texture white on the teeth of the Tiruvachi. So you can add this poster white, or if you don't have texture white on the teeth of this Tiruvachi, don't worry that there is a gold foil. It will stick together and does not fade away even after years. And after this we are going to shade with light pink and sky blue in order to show the fearsome nature of the animal. And I want to share an interesting story. This Thiruvachi is an animal that is, it came from the third eye of Shiva. The story goes like this. Once Shiva got very angry on Raghu, one of the devas. While becoming angry, this Yali animal that is in Thiruvachi, it was destined in such a way that only after eating, it gets satiated. Eating something, it gets satiated. So on seeing this, all other devas, they requested Shiva to forgive Raghu for his mistakes. And immediately Lord Shiva also forgive the Raghu. And finally, that destined Yali was to eat some flesh. So it was searching for the flesh. And Shiva asked that Yali to eat the center part of the flesh, that is its own flesh. Then after it ate the center part of the flesh, Shiva himself went and stood in the center of the Yali, that is Thiruvachi, and that resembles that whenever you are making any mistakes, this Yali will remind us that you should not do any mistakes or else you will be punished. So now the next part is highlighting. So we are going to highlight the flowers and the parrot. And the next query is, can we use natural colors instead of these artificial poster colors? Yeah, you can use natural colors. They were the one used traditionally, but at present natural colors are not available easily and are very rare to maintain also. The stocks also is not available as easy when compared to poster color. So that is the thing. But many artists, they did natural colors with, for example, they took red color from the peepal tree, green color from the some of the leaves, yellow color from some of the flowers, blue from some of the seeds, and black from the black lamp, and the brown from cow dung. And in this we are using orange, red and flesh tint, and also some white also we have added for drawing the lines. We are using this scale, and this is one technique. We are using this liner brush, and the tiles also we are going to decorate it very nicely like this with a chrome yellow and white. You can do it, and in each and every center of that tile we are doing the flowering rangoli like design, so that your floor tiles look like the same as you see in a temple, where it will be filled with all decorations of flower rangoli. There are many more techniques in designing the tiles, and this is one of the basic technique that we use. And you can use burnt sienna as a background, or burnt amber, that is the dark shade, to get a very good lively effect. And now this is the varnish that we are using on this tile. So in this painting we are using all the type of products that we are selling in our store in order to give an idea to our viewers and our customers. So this is my motto. And this is the normal varnish that we sell in our store. You can just buy that by just a WhatsApp. How glossy the floor has become, even giving the designs perfect after overcoated with a varnish. Please use a separate brush while varnishing, or else it will damage the brushes. Now we are going to see the face coloring part. First, you have to draw the line like this, that is for the eyebrows, eyes, nose and also lips. You have to practice this. This is the border of the face. Inside this only the eyes, nose and also the lips should come. So before coloring any face, please practice it in a notebook or a paper, the poster color work, and then start your base coloring work. And this is here also we are going to do the low washing technique. Here we have added white color and olive green, and also in a low washing combination, that is lowest combination. Now we are giving the light for the face. So here, after giving the light of the face, that is a light shade, then we will be putting a dark shade, and this is the brushes that we use, 000000, that is the minute brush shade that we sell in our store. You get a huge control in the variation of shade, that is the minute shade, with these brushes. Now you can see here we are lightening the effect of the shades. So different shades and different combinations, they give a different results. When you see a statue, there will be a light and dark shades. So likewise, we are doing the same with this light and dark technique. And here we are putting more light on the nose, and then we will be reducing it with the black shade, so that the complete picture of the face will be coming out nicely. So you will be seeing it. So this is the black shade we are putting here, how it is coming, you can see here. You can do the same for Andal and also Tayar in Balaji. Also you can do the same technique. This is the same technique, that is black face statue technique is used in these gods. So now we are highlighting the eyebrows and also the eyes, nose, with a black shade, full black shade. And you can see here how it is smiling. The Meenakshi is now started smiling. In Tanjore painting, there are n number of facial expressions for the god. Like for Kali, it is a fierce face expression. For Ram, it is a Raja or authoritative face expression. For Hanuman, it is a service oriented or very humble face expressions. And for Meenakshi, Kamachi, and also for Mahalakshmi, all other gods, it is the symbol of peace face expression. So these are all the face expressions that I know. If you have many others, please give in your comment session. You can see here the eyes of Meenakshi is like a fish. Here in Tamil, Meen means fish. So, and also the Pandyas, the symbol is fish. So here also we are keeping the eyes as a two fish coming center on the nose. So same like that we have made it. And this one is a 3D embossed painting. So the face is somewhat in a oval form. We are also trying our best to bring it on the round form. In Tanjore painting, always note that the face should be in a round form only. Then only it will be very, very attractive and it is traditional. I have seen in many temple the Krishna Leela in Tanjore painting, all are in round face, very beautiful, and mostly they are white in color with white base. Only a small washing of pink or yellow red shades will be there. So that is the traditional work, and now the eyes are coming lively. You can see here how we are putting the eyes with this 000 brush, and you can see this eyes has come very live effect, and the eyebrows are also coming very good. This is a super embossing work, my wife is taking some more time for making it, to do it in a superb way. But if it is a flat work, it would have done in minutes itself. So now you can see here the final finishing has come with a smiling face. So we are going to put next the turmeric and kumkum, which is the symbol of abundance. This kumkum is what every Indian woman wears in her forehead and states that she lives with abundance, like the same Meenakshi who is ruling our Madurai. Thank you so much for watching this video. Kindly like this video if you feel more informative. Waiting for your valuable comments and feedback about these tutorials. And Tanjore painting classes are taken in Madurai, and for all Tanjore painting materials, just WhatsApp me to my mobile number. Now the bindi has been put. Om Meenakshi Namaha. Kindly give us more strength and more peace. You can also worship the same like this after you finish off your own paintings. So that will be more lovely and more sentimental. So this is the next video that we are coming up with, that is full of jewels, how we are making and how to use the AD stones, pearls, half pearls, pavalam, corals and some of the semi-precious stones. Waiting for your valuable comments. Please share this video to your students and friends who want to learn this traditional art. We are also coming up with a CD. You can also purchase it in our two websites or just WhatsApp us. If you follow the 6 tutorials, you will surely learn basics to advanced level of Tanjore painting. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel. Kindly don't forget.